Developments tonight in the ongoing Wright State faculty strike. Tomorrow, an emergency meeting is scheduled between the two sides in front of the state employee relations board. This comes after university officials filed complaints saying the strike is unauthorized. 2 News reporter Judith Rotana is live at Wright State with what's expected to happen tomorrow.
Tomorrow morning, both sides, the university officials and the faculty union, AAUP, will be in Columbus for this hearing. Now, today, the university isn't saying much, only saying that the filing speaks for itself, but the union is talking to us, and they say they're not worried about the outcome.
Everybody's time and energy could have been spent finding a solution.
Now, Aline McElvetta and the AAUP, Wright State's faculty union, are preparing to defend their strike. In a complaint filed by the university, officials say one of the reasons the faculty is on strike, heavy course loads, isn't protected by law. They also say the union told its members to remove their course materials from the university's electronic system.
They're not true. Much of our work is our intellectual property, and it's our right to protect our intellectual property. You don't just hand it out to strangers.
Another claim by the university is the union made it difficult for them to find enough replacement instructors. They say when asked through email, instructors responded with variations of, "Right this minute, I don't feel like I will go on strike whenever one starts."
When everybody has the right to make up their own mind in their own time about whether they take a very major decision in their life and in their career.
McElvetta says the union's strike is legal, and its message is very clear to the university.
In fact, their filing shows that our strike is very effective, that they cannot run the university without us.
Now, tomorrow morning, both sides will have an hour to argue their points. If the board sides with the university, that means that the strike must come to an end. We're told there should be an answer and a conclusion by about 5 o'clock tomorrow evening. This all comes after 2 years of failed negotiations between the university and the union. Live in Fairborn, Judith Rotana, 2 News, working for you.